Hey guys, welcome back to this SQL tutorial series. In this session, we'll learn how to select data from our table. So first, we will work with the select statement and learn how to extract individual columns. Then we will work with the select distinct statement to select only distinct values. So the select query is one of the most important commands in SQL, and it is used to get data from our table. So let's have a look at the syntax. So first, we'd give the keyword select, and then list down all of the column names that we want to select. Following which, we'll give the keyword from, and then finally give the table name from which we are supposed to select these columns. So let's select some data from our employee table. So let's say I want to extract only the employee name column from the employee table. So for that, I would have to give in select, and then I would have to give in the name of the column. So the name of the column is ename, and then I will give in the from keyword. After which, I will give in the name of the table, which is employee. Let me put in semicolon and let me hit execute. Right, so I have successfully extracted only the name column from the entire employee table. So similarly, if I wanted to extract only the age column from the employee table, we would have to put in a similar syntax. So it would be select employee age from, and the name of the table is employee. Execute, right? So we have extracted the age column from the entire employee table. Now we can also extract multiple columns from our table. So for that, we'd have to separate each of the columns with a comma. So let's say I'd want to extract the name column, the gender column, and the salary column from the entire employee table. So let me write the syntax for that. So it would be select. So I will give in the first column, which would be ename. Now I would also want the gender. So I will put in egender, I'll put in a comma, and then I would also want the salary column. So I will put in esalary, after which I will use the from keyword, and then I will give in the name of the table, which would be employee, semicolon, and let me hit execute. Right, so I have extracted three columns from the employee table, and those three columns are ename, egender, and esalary. So this is how we can extract multiple columns from the same table. Now we can also extract the entire data from our table. And to extract the entire data from our table, we'd have to use the asterisk operator. So let me show you guys how it's done. So the command would be select, and then I will put in star, after which it'll be from employee. So as simple as that, guys, select star from employee. So whatever table it is, all you have to do is select star from, and then you'd have to give in the table name. So this is how you can extract all of the data from a particular table. So I will give in semicolon and let me hit execute, right? So when I gave the command select star from employee, I was able to extract all of the data from the employee table. Now let's look at the select distinct statement. So a column often contains many duplicate values, and sometimes we'd want to extract only the distinct values from the column. So this is where select distinct comes in. So the syntax of select and select distinct is pretty much the same. The only difference is we follow up the select keyword with the distinct keyword. Now let's select some distinct values from our employee table. If we have a glance at this gender column, we see that these two values are being repeated. So we just have two values, male and female, and these two values are being repeated. So now if I wanted to extract only the distinct values, so this would be the command for that. So I will type in select, and I'll follow up the select keyword with the distinct keyword. After which I'll give in the column name whose distinct values I'd want. So the column name would be egender, and then it'll be from the name of the table, which is employee. So let's see, what do we get? Select distinct egender from employee. Right, so we see that we only get the distinct values, which are female and male. Now let me actually remove this distinct keyword. And let me hit execute. So let's see what is the difference, right? So if I remove the distinct keyword, we get all of the values. So male, male, female, female, male, and female. Now, so if we use the distinct keyword, we'll only get the values which are different. So these are the cases where select distinct can be used. So this is how we can select data from our table. In the next session, we'll learn how to extract data on the basis of a condition using the where clause. So thanks for attending this session. Let's meet in the next class.